Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure this morning to welcome you to the 11th edition of the Cross Border Distribution Conference. My name is Justin Griffiths. I'm a partner leading our fund registration and regulatory consulting practice in Deloitte and Luxembourg. We have an exciting program today that will cover an extensive range of topics within our industry, from the macroeconomic and geopolitical landscape for funds distribution, to assessing how the democratization of funds could reshape the outlook, and to also exploring if ESG is ripe for reform. We are extremely privileged to have the expertise of distinguished speakers and panelists to debate these topics with us today. There's several regulatory developments on the horizon shaping our industry. I'm not going to mention them. There's a lot of specialists and lawyers in the room, but just maybe two that I would like to highlight. Yesterday, you might have seen that the EU Commission published its legislative proposal on the retail investment strategy, which has the investors' interests at heart, but it also there's some contentious proposals, and I'm sure they'll be debated as part of the panel today and in the coming years as that goes through the process. It's not only in the EU. The Consumer Duty Act, very similarly, is also having sort of far-reaching impacts, starting to impact how we do business and how we communicate with our clients. These and more will be debated by our speakers and panelists during the course of the day. At the end of each session, and obviously time permitting, the moderator may open the floor to questions, and we do encourage you to participate and get involved in the discussion today. This year's conference is the first in-person edition since COVID. Last year, it was hybrid with about 50-50 being virtual and 50% attending in person, where 2021 was completely virtual. For this year's edition, we are glad to welcome participants from 30 different countries. We had 671 registrants, of which about 95% come from Europe, but 5% come from further abroad, from Asia, Middle East, and from the Americas. In total, 370 companies are represented today in the audience. Finally, on an administrative note, I'm pleased to inform you that the sessions will be recorded and made available to registrants for online viewing and access after the conference. On behalf of my partners at Deloitte, I'd like to express my sincere gratitude in advance to our co-organizers, EHP, and to the Financial Times, as well as to our two platinum sponsors, Kahn and Capital Group, and to our gold sponsor, Topan, and our two silver sponsors, Fundinfo and Morningstar. I don't want to also miss out the marketing and events teams from our respective firms who have worked tirelessly over the last couple of months to make this conference possible. Before I hand over to Jerome, there's one important tribute that I would like to make. And for that, I would like to ask my fellow partner, Lou Kish, to come to the stage. Lou, it's a little bit of a surprise, but for those who know Lou, Lou's decided to retire from Deloitte at the end of the month. He'll be at pains to say he's not retiring from the industry. He'll still be actively involved as a non-executive director and as a consultant, but he's decided to step down. And you've had an impressive career in the industry over the last 30 years, and we were very proud at Deloitte to count you as one of our partners for the last 21 years. So in appreciation for your passion, for your dedication, your foresight, he was the founding father of this conference and more than a decade ago, and I know in 2013 when you hosted the first conference. And it's great to see everyone here present. And on behalf of my partners, I'd like to offer you a small token of appreciation. A round of applause for Lou, please. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
We won't let him get to the mic yet. He'll have an opportunity a bit later as a moderator. So on that celebratory note, I hand over to Jerome.
Uh-huh.
Good morning, and thank you, Lou, because this conference is also about friendship. I read a few months ago about a university professor who asked his students to write an essay. At his surprise, the whole class deserved an above-average mark. He became very suspicious when noting, one, that there were very few spelling mistakes, two, that the general structure of the essays was broadly the same, and three, that every essay was referring to a grandmother. And this was, of course, before ChatGPT became known to the wider public. Now, I have to confess, I asked ChatGPT to produce a 5-minute intro for this conference. The result was quite good, I must say. However, first, it looked very similar to Justin's. Second, I can't help thinking that if AI were really intelligent, it would have responded, "Just do it, you moron, you're a lawyer." And thirdly, in 5 minutes is too long, because I just wanted to say thank you for being here, and welcome on behalf of Elvingers, Deloitte, DFT, our sponsors, and of course, my grandmother. Thank you and have a good day.
Justin and Jerome, for your opening remarks. It's great to see the handover to the next generation as well, much as I respect the previous one. And welcome all, ladies and gentlemen, to the Cross-Border Distribution Summit, hosted by Deloitte Luxembourg and Elvinger Hoesch-Prussen, and supported by the Financial Times. I'm accompanied to the Grand Duchy by my fellow journalist, FT journalist Liz Lumley, deputy editor of the Banker, who will be moderating several sessions later in the day. Now, it's always wonderful to be back here in Luxembourg and to see old friends from Deloitte's and Elvinger's, amongst others, a few other regular faces that I recognize here. If I can add my thanks to Lou for supporting us for so many years. You know, the present which you have just handed over to Lou reminds me of the last time Luxembourg won the Eurovision Song Contest in 1983. I can see there's one or two signs of recognition with that. With a number performed by Corinne Hermès, Si la vie est cadeau, if life is a gift. This came just before the 1985 UCITS directive on the marketing of cross-border funds, which indeed was a gift for Luxembourg. But it was not a gift which every country was ready to receive. It took some forward-looking politicians, some innovative lawyers, including those present, and a core of groundbreaking financial services players to build the successful hub we have today. And it would not be fair to say that the song remains the same. Each year, Luxembourg invites new players into the fold, which bring with them high-quality leaders, which we're going to talk about later. It updates its regulations, and it renews its digital infrastructure. As well as building a reputation as Europe's leading fund center, Luxembourg has added new strings to its bow in areas such as alternatives and environmental investing. All these will be discussed in our agenda today. But before we begin, I've been asked to make a couple of housekeeping announcements, namely to request you to switch your mobile phones to silent. I actually don't know how to switch mine to silent. I have to ask my boys how to do that. And to remind you to fill in your delegate feedback forms. I've been told there is no scheduled fire alarm practice, so if the alarm does sound, then please make your way calmly to the exits as guided by our staff. But I can tell you that the agenda today, if not on fire, it's positively smouldering, put together by my FT Live colleague, Yvonne Hines. I'm delighted that so many of you have flown in to join us and contribute to our debate with the high-level speakers. We would like to encourage as many questions as possible at the end of each session. This is not a stage-managed conference with everything prepared. We'd like it to be a genuine forum for ideas and innovation. We only ask that you give us your name, company, and job title before posing a question and waiting for the microphone to reach you. So to provide the the picture of the road ahead for the European funds industry, I'd like to invite to the stage a lady hailed as one of the 100 most influential women in finance in 2022, hopefully in 2023 as well. She's head of asset management at Northern Trust. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Marie Zanis. Lovely to see you.
Thank you.
Just over here, please.